Hello everyone, in this video we will be solving previous year questions from GATE Computer Science. The subject will be digital logic and the topic will be K-maps. Now let us solve these questions one by one. So the first question is, a boolean function f is to be realized only by NOR gates. The K-map is given below. So in the four options we have NOR gates and they have given the K-map. Now how can you implement these gates? So let us do step by step. So first of all, you have to look at what are the max terms here. So we are not going to look at min terms, we are going to look at max terms. So this is a max term, as well as this is also a max term, right? So this is representing A plus B, and this one is representing C plus A, right? Therefore the max term will be A plus B dot C plus A. If you are going to realize this by using OR gates, so this will be your input A and this will be your input B, and I'm going to use an OR gate for them. This is your OR gate, so the output will be A plus B. In the same way, I'm going to use another OR gate. The input will be again A as well as C, so it is going to give us the output which is C plus A. And now I'm going to use an AND gate here, so the output will be A plus B dot C plus A. Now in this case I can convert this circuit to a NOR gate. How? I can use a NOT here as well as I can use a NOT here, so there will not be any change in the circuit. I can use a NOT here and I can use a NOT here, again there will not be any change in the circuit. So you can see these two gates here, they are your NOR gates. And this is representing a NOR gate by De Morgan's law. So by De Morgan's law, this gate, you can change this gate to this. So this I can change using a NOR gate like this. So this is the circuit, how you can implement the same circuit by using OR NOR gates. So output will be the same. So which option is matching? Option A is not matching, option B is not matching, option C is not matching, option D is matching. So for this question, the correct answer is option number D. I hope that you understood the question. Let us move on to the next question. This is a very, very easy question here. Next one, they are saying the boolean function is sum of product where the K-map is given below. Now in this K-map, they are using a variable entrant map. So they have converted a three variable function to a two variable function by using this variable entrant K-map. So we are going to solve this function with the technique of variable entrant. So let us look at this one. So in this case, I can directly tell you the answer here. So telling the answer is very, very easy. So for this problem, first of all, you should know how to convert this using a variable entrant map, or how to solve this variable entrant map. So I'll tell you how to solve this question in two ways. There are two ways of solving the same question. So first way is that you can use the concept of variable entrant. So that is by solving the variable entrant map. And the second method is by expanding all the terms. I'll explain both of them. So let us look at the first part here. So how to solve it by using a variable entrant map. So I'm going to create the same map here. So in the first case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this A as well as A complement as 0, and I'm going to solve and I'm going to find an SOP. So this is B and this is C. I'm going to take both of them as 0, and this will be 1 and this will be 0. Now I will get an equation for this, right? So here you can see this is representing B complement and C complement. This will be the first term, which is B complement and C complement. Now next time I'm going to take this variable A, and I'm going to take this variable A as 1 and other variables are 0. So for variable A, I can solve it this way. I'm going to put this variable A as 1, and I'm going to put this A complement as 0 and any 1 to not, don't care, right? So from here I can get this equation which is representing BC. So this is the term which is representing BC, right? In the same way, I can also solve for this A complementation. So what I'm going to do here in this case is I am going to put A complement as 1, A as 0 and 1 as don't care. And again I am going to try and find the expression. So here you can see this will be your subcube which is possible, and this subcube is representing C complementation. Therefore the equation will be, here I am going to combine A with it, so the equation will be A B C plus, here I am going to combine it with C complement, so A complement C complement plus B complement and C complement. So this will be your solution for this given question by using the method how you solve variable entrant maps. So as you can see, it is a very very easy method and just need a few seconds to solve this problem. Second way is by making the table. So I'm going to make a table here. This is the variable B, this is the variable C, and this is the function F. So what they are trying to say is that whenever this B and C both are 1, so this function is F is giving a value 1. Whenever B is 0 and C is 1, in that case function is giving a value 0. Whenever B is 1 and C is 0, in that case the function is giving a value A complement. And whenever B is 1 and C is 1, in that case the function is giving a value A. Now you can create, you can expand this function completely for all these variables, which is A, B and C, and this is your function F. So whenever this function BC is there, right? So here if A and B can have any values, so the function F is taking a value 1 in both the cases. So this BC can have a value which is 0 1. When this 0 1 is value is there, so function F is giving a value 0 0 even if A is having a value 1 or 0. Whenever this BC is having a value 1 0, in that case function F is giving A complement, right? So here A complement means this will be changed to 1 and this will be changed to 0. And in case of 1 1, this function F is behaving just like A, so that means whatever the value of A is, that will be the value of function F. Now you got the complete function. Now I can make a k-map for this. For a 3 variable function I can easily make a k-map. So here this is A and this is BC. So this is A complement and A, this is B complement C complement, B complement C, BC and BC complement. Now in this case you can see what are the locations where the function is assuming a value 1. So at this location the function is having a value 1, and this location is representing A B complement C complement, which is this location, and this location is representing a value A complement B C complement, so which is this location, and this location is representing this value. So you can now make subcubes here. So this subcube is representing a value which is B complement C complement. Now this subcube here, it is representing a value which is A B C, and this one can be combined using this. Aap in dono combine kar sakte hain. So after combining both of them, this will give us A complement and C complement. So again equation we will get is A B C plus B complement C complement plus A complement and C complement. So you can see you can get the same answer from both the cases. Exactly the same way you can solve this problem easily. Now let us look at this next problem. What is the equivalent minimal Boolean expression for the following k-map? So a k-map is given. Now I have to find the equivalent Boolean expression for this. It's very very easy, as you can see, one of the easiest question that you can ever come across, very straightforward question. So this is a subcube which is possible, as well as all these ones will create one subcube. So this subcube is representing D and B, and this subcube here, it is representing B complement and D complement. So the equation will be B complement D complement plus BD, which is equal to B XNOR D. So this entire k-map is representing the term B XNOR D. It is so easy, as you can see, right? There's no doubt in this. The easiest question that ever come across in gate examination. So in this question they have given a k-map, and they're saying what is the equivalent Boolean expression in the product sum form of the k-map. What is the Boolean expression that you can have? So here this is a subcube which is possible. This will be one subcube, and you can also have this as a subcube. So there are two subcubes are possible. So this subcube is representing a value which is D complement, and from here it is B, so it is B D complement, correct? And I think this is right, so it is b, and from here it is d complement, right? And this subcube is representing a value which is d as well as b complement. So we get b d complement plus b complement d, which is b xor d, right? But as you can see, this is actually matching with the option number a. So if SOP is asked, because this is a product, sum of product, if sum of product is asked, then option number a will be the answer. But the problem is, they are asking product of sum, they are not asking sum of product, they are asking product of sum, or you can say POS expression. So because they are asking POS expression, so I'm going to take all these zeros, right? So for POS expression, this will be a subcube, as well as all these corner zeros will make another subcube. So this subcube is representing the product term, which is d complement plus b complement, and this corner one is representing the product term, which is your d complement, and we have it is representing d plus b. So you can see, if you combine it, so it is b plus d dot b complement plus d complement, which is representing the option number c. So option number c is the correct answer for the given question. I feel that this is again an easy question. The thing is, you should not miss the term product of sum, because they are asking product of sum. Many times people make mistake, they ignore such things, so you cannot miss those problems things, right? Now what is this question? They are giving us a k map. Now this one very interesting thing here, what they have done is, instead of writing 1 1 here, they have written, they have interchanged these two columns, right? So because they have interchanged these two columns, because of that 90% students will make mistake in the examination, because they will think that this will be a subcube. But you can see, this will not be a subcube, because you have to see these things very carefully in the examination. Now here you can see, this will be a subcube as well as this will be a subcube. We cannot have that bigger subcube. So this subcube is representing the term which is BC, and this subcube is representing the term B complement C complement, which is BC plus B complement C complement, that is representing B XNOR C. But if you know the property of XNOR, XNOR is basically a complement of XOR. So this can be written as B XOR C whole complement, which is matching the option number C. So option number C is the correct answer for this problem. Now let us look at this next question. Which of the following function implements the k-map shown below? So we have four functions. Let us first solve the k-maps, and then we will see later on. So here this can be a subcube, as well as this can also be a subcube. So I've created two subcubes here. So this subcube is representing the value a and d, and this subcube is representing a value which is c and d. So that means I should get ad plus cd. I can take d as common, so it is a plus c dot d. So again, very easy question, very straightforward question. You can never get a question which is easier than this. Very easy question for gate exam, very easy question. Now which function does not implement k-map given below? Which of these function is not implementing the above k-map? So you can see, for this k-map there are many different outputs are possible, right? So let me go through all the outputs one by one. I can make this subcube, and secondly I can make this subcube. So these two subcubes are possible. So this subcube is representing the value xy, and this subcube is representing the value y and w. Therefore it will be xy plus wy. So xy plus wy is basically representing your option number b, as well as it is also representing your option number a. So it is wy and this is xy. So option number a and b both are same, and option number a and b can be implemented very easily. But can we implement this option number c? Kya aap option number c ko implement kar sakte hain? Can we implement this option number c? So you can see, this option number c is basically your POS expression, that is product of sum expression. So we have to make product of sum from this k-map. I can make this bigger subcube, as well as I can use this subcube. This will be very very big subcube, as well as I can also make this one, right? So if I make this subcube here, so your term will be only y, right? And nothing else will come. And if I make this subcube, so your term that will come is going to be the term that will come is going to be your x plus w. Therefore the term that will come is x plus w dot y, again which is matching with option number A, right? So basically option number A, they wanted to give a product of some expression. This is what they wanted to give, a sum of product expression, right? So obviously option number A and B are possible, but still, can we make option number C? So in option number C, you can see that all this product term are having two variables, right? I mean two literals in each of this product term. So that means I have to make a subcube maximum of size 4. Can I get a subcube of maximum of size 4? Yes, I can. How I can do that? So I can make a subcube like this here. I can make this as a subcube, correct? As well as I can make this as a subcube, correct? As well as I can make this as a subcube. So because all three of these subcubes are of size 4, I'm not making a size 8 subcube, because here all these terms are basically your size 4 terms. So this one is representing the term which is x complement plus y. This subcube is representing a term which is y plus w. And this one is representing a term which is x plus w. Okay. So this is y, I think, yes, y plus, and here this will be here it will be w is there, so it is w complement, y plus w complement. So that means I will get a term which is x plus w dot x complement plus y dot w complement plus y, which is option number C. Therefore option number C is also matching. So that means A, B, C and all of them are matching. Okay, so all of these can be implemented. Therefore the correct answer will be option number D. So all three of them can be implemented, and they are asking not implemented, right? So option number D jo hai, that will be a correct answer for this given problem. Now let us look at next one. Given the following K map, which of the following represents the minimal SOP for this K map? Minimal sum of product expression jo hai, what will be the minimal SOP? So we can see SOP they are asking. So I can make a subcube here, as well as I can make a subcube here. It's very easy, the easiest question. So this subcube is representing y complement z, and this subcube is representing y, and we have x. Therefore it is y complement z plus yx, which is equal to y complement z and yx. As you can see, option number A is directly matching. Very easy and straightforward question. You cannot get a question which is easier than this. Very easy question. Again, minimum sum of product, that is SOP expression for this function in the given K map. What is the SOP expression for this given function? As you can see here, I can make this as a subcube, as well as I can make this as a subcube. So there are two subcubes are possible. So this subcube is representing a term which is z complement dot x, and this subcube is representing a term which is z dot, and the second term that is not changing is x complement. So it is z complement x plus x complement z, which is x x or z, and this is matching the option number B. So option number B is a correct answer for this given problem. Next, the literal count of the boolean expression is the sum of number of times each literal appears in the expression. For example, the literal count of this expression is 4. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. So every time you have a variable, you have to count as a literal. So there are 4 literals here. What is the minimum possible literal count of the product of sum and sum of product representation respectively for the of the following given of the function given by the K map? So here X represents the don't care condition. So they're asking what is the minimum number of literals in product of sum, as well as sum of product expression. Okay, so product of sum and sum of product expression, what is the minimum number of literals you can have? So let us first take your SOP. Okay, so in case of SOP, what are the subcubes you can make? You can make all these corners as one subcube, fine, and then you can make this as another subcube, and then you can also make this as another subcube. So there are 3 subcubes are possible. So here this outer subcube is representing a value which is the value that is not changing is y complement dot, second value is w complement, right? And this subcube is representing a value which is your x complement, z complement w, and this subcube is representing a value which is z complement w complement, and we have x. Therefore, the expression will be x z complement w complement plus x complement z complement w plus you have y complement and w complement. This will be your expression. Now you can see in this expression the number of literals. So yahan par jo literals hain, so how many literals are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So there are total of 8 literals in SOP expression. SOP mein total 8 literals hai. So you can see in none of these options, kisi bhi option ke andar, we do not have 8 as the answer. The closest possible answer is 9 or 10, right? So we do not have 8 in the answer. So you can see that means the options given in this question, they are wrong. But again, let us also figure out what is the number of literals in product of some expression. We know here that SOP expression is containing 8 literals, but let us look at POS expression, that is product of some expression. So in case of your product of some expression, we can make these subcubes. We can make this as a subcube. This is a subcube which is possible. And a part of this, we can make, I can use all of them here. This is also a subcube which is possible. And I can use this as a subcube, as well as I can use this as a subcube. So these subcubes I'm using. Now using this subcube is giving us a value which is your x complement plus y, and this subcube is giving us a value which is x plus y complement plus w, and this subcube is giving us a value which is w complement plus z complement plus x complement, right? And this subcube is giving us a value which is your what is this value? This is your y complement plus, and this value is z complement, right? So what is the expression? The expression is x complement plus y dot x plus y complement plus w dot w complement plus z complement plus x complement dot y complement plus z complement. So here number of literals, how many literals will be there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So there are total of 10 literals in this expression. There are total of 10 literals in this expression. But is it possible that a product of some expression is possible even less than 10 literals? Kya 10 literals se kam product of some expression possible hai? Yes, that is also possible. How can we make an expression which is even having less than this much? So what you can do is you can combine this subcube of size 4. You can combine this subcube, again a subcube of size 4, and then you can also make this subcube, again this is also a subcube of size 4, and then you can make this subcube which is a subcube of size 2. So here you can see we have created 4 subcubes here. So this subcube is representing a value which is x complement plus w complement. This subcube is representing a value which is y complement plus z complement, and this subcube is representing a value which is w complement plus z complement, and this subcube is representing a value which is your x plus y complement plus w. Therefore the expression will be x complement plus w complement dot y complement plus z complement dot w complement plus z complement dot x plus y complement plus w. So if you count the total number of literals, so it is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So there are total of 9 literals. So that means in POS expression we are getting 9 literals, in SOP expression we are getting a total of 8 literals. So none of these answers are matching. So either I can maybe say in examination I will skip this question, because again I can say that none of these options are correct. But even if I have to mark option, then I can say option number C is the closest one to the answer. Option number C jo hai wo answer ke sabse close hai. So either I can mark option number C. I will not be able to mark option number A, because at least in option number C one option is matching. Only one option is matching, so I can mark option number C. Now, is there any short trick to count the number of letters? क्या number of letters को count करने के लिए कोई short trick available है? See, this K map is of 4 variables. So, the number of variables is 4. So, whenever you are going to create a subcube, so according to the size of subcube, it is going to reduce the number of literals in that particular expression. For example, this subcube is of size 4. 4 means it is 2 raised to power 2. So that means I'm going to subtract this 2 from this number 4. So which is 4 minus 2 is equal to only 2. So that means this subcube is going to give us 2 literals. Is subcube se hame 2 literals milenge. So you can see what are those literals. So which is x complement plus we have w complement. So only 2 literals are there. So in the same way, even if you have POS expression or even if you have SOP expression, any expression whatsoever. So for example, I can make, in this case, I can make a SOP expression here. Let us suppose this is your SOP expression, right? So this is your sum of product expression. For this sum of product expression, the size is 4. So which is again 2 raised to power 2. So if you are going to create any, SOP expression or min term from this, so that min term will be having only 2 literals. So min term ke andar sirf 2 literals honge. So you do not really have to calculate the entire expression, just like I have calculated entire expressions here. I do not really have to calculate the entire expressions. Without even calculating also, I can solve the same question. Now let us look at the next question. The Boolean function for a combinational circuit with 4 inputs is represented below. Now, which of the following product terms given below is an essential prime implicant of the function? So if you have an implicant, which is covering a term that is not covered by anyone else, that is called as your essential prime implicant. So first of all, let us see what are the implicants that are possible here. So we can have this as an implicant. Ye ek implicant possible hai. Let me just change the size. So this is an implicant. A part of this, we can also have this as an implicant. Then we can have this as an implicant. Then again, we can have this as an implicant. Then again here, we can have this thing as an implicant. And again, we can make this last one. I can combine all the corner ones together. So I can combine all of these corner ones in one. So this, 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 and this to make a huge subcube. So you can see this can also be covered here. So this huge subcube, this will be your essential prime implicant. Why? It is covering two terms, that is, it is covering one term that is not covered by anyone else, right? It is covering this term. Let me show you the term also. This is the term which is not covered by anyone else. Okay, I guess I can also cover it with someone else. Okay, so I can cover that one. Okay, let me make again. So here I can make all these corner ones together. I can make a subcube with all these corner ones. And a part of this, I can make the following subcubes also. I can make this as a subcube. I can make this as a subcube. And a part of this, I can also make this as a subcube. I can make this as a subcube. I can also make this as a subcube. Main yahan par isko bhi ek subcube bana sakta hun. And in the same way, I can combine, this is a subcube I can make. So I think the corner one here, that will be your essential prime implicant. So because that is a prime implicant, which is not a part of any other implicant, plus it will be your essential prime. So this blue one here, the corner ones, that is your essential prime implicant here, right? So your corner is representing essential prime will be of size 2. It will be a size 2 because it is containing 4 elements. What are those 4 elements? 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it is containing 4 elements. So the size is 4, which is 2 raised to power 2. So you can see here that we have 4 variables. Out of 4 variables, I'm going to eliminate 2 variables because of this. So the size will be 2. So just by looking at this, you can eliminate option number A, B, C. You can see option number D is the correct answer. But again, if you want to find the value of this corner one, so the value of this will be Q complement and X complement. Okay, so you do not really, you know, have to get answers just by the formulas or numbers. You can say the option number D will be a correct answer because the biggest subcube that is possible here, that biggest subcube is essential prime. Jo yahan par sabse bada subcube hai, wohi essential prime hai. Aur sabse bade subcube ka size hai 4. So because the biggest subcube is having a size 4, that is why out of 4 terms, I'm going to remove 2 terms. So your min term will be having two terms only. Okay, next question. Consider the following expression. Which of the following k maps currently represents the expression? इसमें से किस k map से हमें ये expression मिलेगी? Now you can see in all of these k maps they are only giving us a don't care. We are only having a don't care. We are not having any one and we are not having any zero. So let us look at the first k map here. So in the first k map, I can make different subcubes. I can make this as a subcube, as well as I can make this as a subcube, as well as I can also use this as a subcube, right? So if I'm using this subcube, so this subcube is representing the term which is A, and the next term is D complement. This subcube is representing a term which is A complement and C complement, and this subcube is representing a term which is your C complement D, and we have B. So the expression will be A complement C complement plus A D complement plus C complement DB. So check with our options. So here A D complement, it is coming. A complement C complement is coming, and B C complement D, it is coming. So that is why option number A is the correct answer for this problem. The first option was correct. Okay, I hope that you understood this very easy question. Next, consider the following expression. Which of the following expression does not correspond to the k map obtained for the above expression? इस expression से जो कौन सा ऐसा expression है नीचे जो इसके k map को represent नहीं करता? Okay, so let us make this expression first of all. इस expression को हम लोग सबसे पहले बनाते हैं. So here it is having four variables A, B, C and D. So there are four variables. So my k map will be containing a total of four variables. So this is your k map. Okay, it will be having a total of four variables. This is variable AB and this is variable CD. So it is A complement B complement, A complement B, A complement B, then AB, and this is A B complement. This is C complement D complement, C complement D, CD and C D complement. Now in this case, this is A D complement. So wherever we have A D complement, I'm going to put a 1. So where are the locations where you have A D complement? This is A and D complement, as well as this is A and D complement, as well as this is also A and D complement, and this is also A and D complement, right? Second term will be your A complement C complement. So A complement C complement, here we have A complement C complement, and here also we have A complement and C complement. Third term will be B C complement D B C complement D. So B C complement D will be this term. This term is there, B C complement D. Now I've got this K map, and for this K map I have to tell which of the expression is matching. Now let us look at this one. So what are the subcubes that are possible here? कौन कौन से subcube possible है? So I can have, okay, first option से match करते हैं. So here we have C complement D complement. So C complement D complement is this subcube. This subcube is representing C complement and D complement. Second is A D complement. So A D complement, we have A and D complement. So A D complement is basically this subcube. This is A D complement. Third is A B C complement. So we have A B and C complement. You can see here that do we have A B C complement? A is here, B is here, and C complement is here. So that means we are making this subcube. So this subcube is representing your A B and C complement. Okay. In the same way, the last term is A complement C complement D, and you can see that this subcube is representing A complement C complement and D. Therefore you can see option number A jo hai, it is possible. Option number A can be created using this k map. So option number A is possible. So let us look at the option number B. So we'll figure out is option number B possible or not. Anyways, so is option number B possible or not? In option number B we have C complement D complement, so obviously it can be created. We have A complement and C complement. So A complement and C complement is basically this subcube. This subcube is your A complement and C complement. So this is also possible. Then we have A D complement. So A D complement, AD complement is this subcube. So this subcube, I think it is representing AD complement. ठीक है, this is AD complement. And then we have ABC complement D, and you can see this is representing ABC complement D. So option number B is also possible. Option number B can also be done with it. Option number B को भी आप बना सकते हैं. ठीक है, I hope that you understood this part. Okay, now check out the option number C. So in option number C we have A complement and C complement. So A complement and C complement is this subcube. This is your A complement and C complement. Then we have the second term is, let me just rub it. Right, so here the second term is A D complement. So is there anyone here, is there A D complement here? A and D complement, A and D complement. So you can see I can make this subcube, and this subcube is representing A D complement. Third term is representing A B C complement. So we have A B C complement. So in this case we have A is here, and we have B. So B is, so A B C complement, right? So A B is here and C complement is here. So I can make this subcube, which is A B C complement, I guess, right? So A B and C complement, right? And then the fourth one is C complement D. So C complement D, as you can see here, I think we cannot make C complement D. तो यहाँ पर C complement D is not possible, correct? So yes, C complement D is not possible. So I'll say option number C cannot, we cannot make. I can do option number A, I can make option number B, as well as I can make option number D, but I cannot make option number C because of this term. This term is not possible here in this diagram. Let us look at the next question. In the K-map shown below, X denotes the don't care. What is the minimal form of the functions represented by the K-map? So they're asking what the minimal SOP is possible, because in all the options they are giving SOPs only. So what is the combinations that you can make? You can combine these two, okay, as well as you can combine all these four corners. So these two subcubes are possible, that's it. So this subcube, this corner subcube, is representing a value which is D complement, and we have a B complement. And this black subcube is representing a value which is your D complement as well as your A complement. So we have A complement, D complement, plus B complement and D complement. So which is matching with the option number A. As you can see, very easy question. Option number A is the correct answer. One of the easiest questions that you can ever come across for gate. Next. What is the minimal form of K-map shown below? Assume that X denotes the don't care combination. So all the options here are giving SOP. So I'm going to find a sum of product expression for this, or you can say SOP expression for this. So I can combine all these four corners, right? A part of this I can combine these two. So only two subcubes are fine. So obviously I can remove option number D. I can remove option number C because it is having four terms, right? So I can remove option number A also. Very easy. I can directly say that option number B will be the answer even without calculating their values. But again, let me calculate the values here. See, because here two subcubes are possible and size of both the two subcubes is 4. So obviously both the terms should have two literals, right? So here you can see this corner one is representing the term which is D complement, and we have a B complement, this corner one. And this pink one is representing the term which is C complement, and we have a B complement, right? So that is why you can see option number B is directly matching. So that is the correct answer for this given question. Then this is a K-map. They are saying consider the K-map given below, and they are asking the blank represents 0, assuming all the inputs A, B, C, D respective complements A complement, B complement, C complement, D complement are also available. The above logic is implemented using a two input NOR gates. The minimum number of gates required is, for this question, what is the minimum number of gates that are required? So first of all, let us try and solve this question. इस क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करते हैं. लेट अस ट्राई एंड मिनिमाइज दिस एक्सप्रेशन. सो वी कैन मेक दिस सब क्यूब, एंड दिस नो नीड ऑफ मेकिंग एनी अदर सब क्यूब. सो दिस सब क्यूब इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ वैल्यू विच इज सी एज वेल एज ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो वी हैव सी ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट, राइट? सो दैट मीन्स वी हैव टू इम्प्लीमेंट सी ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट. वी हैव टू इम्प्लीमेंट सी ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट यूजिंग the two input NOR gate. Using the two input NOR gate. NOR gate, right? So we have to implement this function. Okay. So how will we implement? How can we implement? So they are saying their complements are also available. This is very interesting. They are saying, assuming that all inputs A, B, C, D are available, as well as their complements are also available, you can directly give complement as an input, right? So that means this A complement C can be written as, if you take A complement C, it can also be written as A plus C complement whole complement, right? So by De Morgan's law, this can be written as A complement dot C. So I can implement this using a NOR gate. I can use this NOR gate here, and in this NOR gate I can directly give A and I can directly give C complement. So that means only one NOR gate is required to implement this circuit, right? So here this term is very important here. As you can see that complements are also available. Agar complements available nahi hote, then in that case you need two NOR gates, because the complements are also available. So that is why aapko sirf ek NOR gate ki hi requirement hai. Now they are saying, consider the three, four variable functions. Aapke paas functions hain f1, f2, f3, and all these four, these are four variable functions. Now, which of the following circuit with AND gate and one XOR gate input function can be expressed? तो इसमें से ये कौन सा function जो है यहाँ पर represent कर रहा है, right? तो let us figure it out. तो पहला जो function है यहाँ पर जो f1 function है, so f1 is representing the values which is 0, 2, 5, 8 and 14, right? Let me write it clearly. So f1 function is representing a value which is 0, 2, 5, 8 and 14. And f2 function is representing a value which is 2, 3, 6, 8, 14 and 15. So when I'm going to use the AND gates, so that means I'm taking the intersection. So only those values will come which comes in the intersection. So 2 and 2 is common, so 2 will come here. And here you can see that 8 and 8 is common, so therefore 8 will come here. 14 and 14 is common, therefore 14 will come here, right? So only these three terms will come. And F3 is 2, 7, 11 and 14. Now I'm using exclusive OR. So exclusive OR means that I'm going to get those values which is available in one and not available in another, right? So because we know in case of XOR, when we have 1 and 0, then only it is having a value 1, or 0 and 1, then only it is having a value 1. So we have to search those values which is available in one but not in other. For example, 2 is available in both of them, so XOR will not give this answer. 7 is only available in F3, so 7 is going to be here. 8 is only available in this function, not in another function, so 8 will also be here. 11 is only available in this function, not with other, so 11 will come here. And 14 is not is available in both of them. So the output will be summation 7, 8 and 11. 7, 8 and 11 will be your output. So correct answer is option number A. As you can see, very easy question, and maybe you are not going to spend a lot of time in examination based on this very, very easy question. And I hope that you liked the video. If you liked it, please hit like button and share it with your friends. Have a nice day.